According to the residents, contractors have abandoned the sites and they dumped construction materials along the roadsides, hence affecting movements for the pedestrians. The decision to close the channels followed an incident on Monday morning when a vehicle transporting business people to Ukubani Market in Ariwa sub-county almost overturned at one of the spots near Geya Primary School as the driver failed to negotiate through the narrow path with a lot of potholes as one side of the road is totally closed for the construction works. Kemisi Yabani added that many other road users have also been involved in accidents at the same spot.
It's almost a month. UNR is not responding to covering up this and completing the culvert point where two vehicles had fallen here last week, and this morning the vehicle taking the businessmen and women to Okuban Market almost turned down, and it prompted me to go to the office of Resident District Commissioner and my district DLC, where we have agreed to come and temporarily cover the portal to prevent losses of Ugandans along this national road.
The narrow road has affected flow of traffic on the same road since the culverts fixed on one side of the road have not been covered.
We are not happy because of this area here. Now when UNR intervened here of recent, when this culvert was supposed to be entered, we are happy. But now, time and again, accidents have been caused here. Now we don't know what is the problem. You can even see from there passing has been a problem. The youth, no normal people here get the accident here time and again. We don't know where to report. So we are requesting government to at least to help and cover this thing and bridge it.
Drasi Kalafani Ali, the Secretary for Works and Transport in Yumbe District, blamed the UNRA team for not closely monitoring projects after signing contractors.
Them UNRA, I don't see the concern which brought them here. Because if you block the road completely for some period of a month, and within the center of the town, then you are not serious. If the other routes, which are, you know, going outside the town, were also well made, then it could be well, except one, which is the so-called tarmac part. But the other routes, they are destroying everything by the sub-county because the capacity of vehicles moving on those roads is not really prepared for actually large vehicles. That is actually equally a damage, more damage.
Meanwhile, the Uganda National Roads Authority station manager for Moyo Station, Julius Mwesuga, refuted the claim by the community that the sites have been abandoned. He said the absence of the contractor at the site is to allow the concrete on the side of the road to dry at least for 28 days. Report by Adam Gule for the news.